The COVID-19 pandemic appears to be shaking multilateralism to its very foundation. It's leading some to seek easy answers, to lock themselves away in their small territories. And yet, the scope of the crisis plainly shows that the joint efforts of all countries are needed today more than ever, that we must collaborate to overcome this situation, and that we must do so through the mechanisms available at the United Nations. It is time to go back to we, the peoples of the United Nations. The UN is much, much more than a peacekeeping organization. It feeds millions of people every day. It vaccinates almost half of the world's children. It offers protection to civilians trapped in conflict. It engages with environmental issues. It safeguards human rights. It helps with health and medical research, with education, with the empowerment of women around the world, and countless other issues. Of course, the UN is not perfect. It can and must do better. And it is incumbent upon all of us to strive to improve it. This is a responsibility shared by all its members. Dialogue, solidarity, tolerance are required more urgently now than ever before. It is precisely when the winds of misfortune blow that we understand the need for trans-border, transgenerational cooperation to continue on the same course, the course of our common humankind. This is why I encourage you, especially you young people, to participate in the biggest ever global conversation launched to commemorate the United Nations 75th anniversary. What kind of future do we want to create? Are we on the right track? What measures are needed to close the gaps in our societies? How do we promote peace? It is our world and our future. So it is time for all of us everywhere to discuss what we want our future to look like together. Have your say. It's up to you.